And then in our ninth episode, which is our mid-season finale, we get to see our version of Holidays with the originals. It's, you know, there's something that's a Louisiana tradition that's been around since about the 1700s called bonfire season, where starting in the beginning of December, they'll start to build bonfires out by the water and, you know, back in the day, all around on the land. And it's kind of almost like a wooden version of a Christmas tree. And so all through December leading up to actually, you know, Christmas Eve, there's just fires burning, you know, through the city. And so we decided to take that folklore and make it our own, as though the originals had actually been the ones to bring it with them from Europe or from Mystic Falls to Louisiana. Like I said, we've got, you know, bonfire season holiday where we actually will get to see our family kind of come together, not necessarily under the best of circumstances, but, you know, be able to have moments with each other as they build their next layer of strategy for how to deal with their mother, who has really, at this point, they've realized is so far out of control and is making such tremendous steps to get what she wants that they don't think she will ever stop until she actually succeeds. And so it's like, how do we deal with this person and her acolyte, son, Finn, who are never going to let us rest? And the danger just keeps getting closer and closer and closer to home.
Phoebe had teased that we're going to have to wait a little bit before we get our Haley Hope reunion. What can you tease about that reunion? And when are we going to get to know a little bit about Hope's, like, biological makeup?
You actually don't have to wait as long as she might have teased for that reunion. I think that, without being too spoilery, I do think that sometimes the holidays come with a little extra surprises. So that's all I'll say about that. But in terms of Hope's biological makeup, you know, there's a lot of things coming up in the second half of the season, which is, what is this curse of the firstborn? What does it mean? What does it mean for Hope? What is the fact that Hope is, you know, born to witch blood, born of, you know, werewolf descent, and also born, you know, sort of as a progeny of a vampire? What does that mean? And while we'll never kind of drop that all on you at once, little things will start to materialize that will make us realize that there is something extraordinary about this baby, not just because she's so damn cute, but because, you know, she is sort of the trifecta of all the supernatural beings, and how will that manifest?
Can you tease anything about the Jackson and the Pack?
Yes. It's good. It's so good. I love Jackson, and I love what he's trying to do with Haley. You know, as we did see last night, right? The journal.
The angel, the picture.
Oh no, that's next episode. Okay. So next week's episode will basically give us the first real solution that has come their way as far as how they could unite all the packs, and also rescue them from this sort of indentured servitude that they've fallen into by accepting these moonlight rings. As Aiden says in an upcoming episode, these rings make us strong, they make us able to control ourselves, they, you know, we don't have to be suffering from the curse in the way that we were suffering, so why would anybody give them up? You know, even though, yes, we have to do what Finn says and we have to be his lackeys, but we are still stronger and more powerful and, frankly, happier than we've been, you know, in a long time. And so Haley and Jackson they discover a solution that is very untraditional and oddly romantic. And that's all I can say on the matter. But it's going to give us a nice run of a Haley Jackson storyline that I think is going to be pretty special.
Does that mean there might not be much hope for, like, Haley and Elijah or Haley and Klaus right now?
I wouldn't go writing off Haley and Elijah anytime soon. In fact, along with the holidays often comes some, you know, some joy and cheer in that area too. And that's all I'll say about that. But, you know, I think that the saddest thing about Elijah is he, whether it's through conditioning of his mother or just his own sense of you know, self-loathing, he genuinely believes that if he loves too deeply, he will hurt the person that he cares for. And that coupled with the fact that Haley is raising, you know, that Haley is the mother of this child that's not his, and this is, you know, the mother of his brother's child. There's like this hands off that he needs to feel with her, but it's so hard because he deeply cares for her. And so we'll really get to watch that struggle moving forward for both of them. You know, he's been blowing Haley off all year, and it's been kind of killing her a little bit. So she'll finally get to confront him about that, and they'll have it out a little bit, and we'll try to start getting the sense of where everybody stands in that relationship. Not to say it's going to end, you know, in flowers and rainbows, but it's definitely going to be very profound.